हेलो गाइस, वी आर करंटली डिस्कसिंग यूनिट नंबर 4, पेमेंट अंडर जीएसटी। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर लर्निंग व्हाट इज द जीएसटी पेएबल बाय रेगुलर रजिस्टर्ड पर्सन एंड देन कंपोजिशन रजिस्टर्ड पर्सन, राइट। लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द रजिस्टर्ड पर्सन हु हैज टेकन रजिस्ट्रेशन अंडर रेगुलर स्कीम। Regular scheme means we are speaking about section 22 and section 24. So here, this is the formula that we have been using since ages, right? GST payable is equal to output tax liability minus input tax credit. That is the GST payable through GST e-cash ledger, right? So output tax liability is registered as per valuation of supply as given under section 15 of CGST Act 2017 and relevant rules. So output tax liability, this is what we calculate as per section 15 of CGST Act, and there are some relevant rules. These rules range from rule 27 to rule 35 of CGST rules 2017, okay. And this input tax credit, that is calculated as per ITC rules given under section 16 to 21 of CGST Act and relevant rules. Okay, so after valuation rules, after rule 35, that starts from rule 36 till rule 44, we have rules which are given for ITC, okay, CGST rules. And then in both the cases above, amendments, notifications, circulars and guidance notes are to be followed as required from time to time, because they have been there are many changes. There have been changes in section 15 and relevant rules, in section 16 to 21 and relevant rules of CGST Act, and those changes are done through amendments, notifications, circulars and guidance notes. Okay, so that is how we learn the GST payable by the regular registered person. That is the GST payable. Okay, this is what we have learned. Now, what is the GST payable by registered person under composition scheme? Composition dealer shall comply with Section 10 of CGST Act 2017. Okay, Section 10 is the special section given for composition dealer. The GST payment for composition dealer is comparatively simpler. Now, why it is simpler? It is because the dealer who has opted for composition scheme has to pay the fixed percentage of GST on the total outward supplies made. Okay, there are no rules like this. There are no rules and no sections have been given, right? It is this simple chart they have given, and GST is to be paid based on the type of business of a composition dealer as an aggregate percentage. Like, see, for manufacturers and traders, for goods suppliers, that is 1% GST is payable, right, as a composition dealer. And for restaurants who are not serving alcohol, but if you serve the alcohol, you compulsorily have to take registration under normal scheme. Okay, such restaurants who are not serving alcohol for human consumption, 5% is the rate of tax for the composition dealer, and for all service providers, that is 6%, and that is bifurcated equally between CGST and SGST. This is the chart. Okay, this chart is very important. Students, copy this please. Now, can you pay GST being an unregistered person is the question. The answer is yes. See, who is a registered person? Even if the registration is under process and you have not taken registration, still you will be called as unregistered person. So unregistered persons need not pay GST, okay, because you are not registered. Because why you are not registered? either it is because you are not a businessman, or even if you are a businessman, your supply is not defined under section 22 or section 24 or section 27. Okay, so you are the unregistered person and therefore you need not pay any GST. As a customer or consumer or client, is any unregistered person, okay, if any there is a customer or a consumer or client and they are the unregistered person is paying GST, it is just an indirect tax on such goods or services are both consumed. Consumer, there is a difference between customer and consumer. Customer can be a businessman, can be, maybe, okay, but here consumer is the final consumer who consumes the goods and services, and therefore he is an unregistered person. Client can be a consumer or client can be a customer. That is a different name for different profession, right? So that can be a consumer, and therefore if they are paying GST, that is only an indirect tax, and such payment, for making such payment, you need not take registration in GST. Okay, so this payment is not made to the government but made to supplier, and supplier will make payment to the government. It is not your job to pay it to the government directly because you are not registered, right? So in case where unregistered person is supplying goods or services to a registered person, GST shall be paid by recipient on behalf of supplier. This scheme is called reverse charge. You know about this, I need not explain, right? Section 9, subsection 3 and 4, right? In unique cases where unregistered person has applied for registration, but GSTIN is not generated, it means the registration process is still in progress. Okay, GSTIN is not yet generated. Such persons can make GST payment using TRN, that is temporary registration number. Right? So this is how you are paying GST. Total amount of tax payable A, let us call that as A, and interest, late fee, penalties, whatever, that is B, and then amount of tax payable, point number 3, amount of tax payable along with interest on account of mismatch of credit based on provisions of section 29 or section 29A or section 43C, right? For such cases, we are just adding it here, right? Why we are adding it? Because interest is included on account of mismatch of credit. Any other amount payable by the taxpayer or directed by the board on account of any proceedings carried out. Proceedings carried out, why it is carried out? It is as directed by the board. Or any other amount which is payable by the taxpayer, we are just adding it here, right? This can be a notice from a GST officer that you have not paid the taxes, please pay it. So that is D, and you have to add it. And then TDS and TCS, tax deducted at source and tax collected at source, we are just adding that here, right? Please remember, tax deducted at source, we are not adding this, I'm sorry, we are not adding this. It is because it is deducted, right? Earlier it was deducted, and because you may not have paid the taxes, right? If you want to know more about this, the concept of TDS, I have already made a concept on TDS. Please watch that video, the link will be given in the description, right? TCS video is already made. So these two things we are just deducting because, see, it is already deducted, it is already collected. Now you need not pay anymore. Tax payable under reverse charge Yes, we are deducting these two because it is already paid by the supplier. Amount payable by the department against interest. By the department means government. If government is about to pay you something, you have to deduct that too. Why increase the transaction, right? Government paying you and you paying it back to the government. See, amount payable by the government against any interest. If government is paying any interest or refund or penalty or late fee or any other amount as determined under the proceedings under this act, this act means CGST Act. In such cases, what we are doing, that is H we are deducting, right? So electronic tax liability ledger will show this amount, which amount A plus B plus C plus D. Add these four and deduct these four. E, F, G, H, C. A, B, C, D. Add these four, deduct these four. Right? This is what we are following for calculating the GST payable. Right? Hope this is understood to you. And that's all for today's class. This was very important class because we have seen the difference between the calculation of GST payable by the unregistered person, by the composition person and the regular registered person. That's all for today's class, friends. In next video, we will see the next things, right? See you in next video. Thank you.